Not until after the game.
Okay. You ever do that before?
No.
Never. Okay.
I was saving it for the
good time to do it.
The plan after Thursday, when we won, we're gonna watch the first half of the game, see what we got, and then the game was so competitive and it was a great game that we're guys looked up at me. I was sitting, you know, a little above them. They said like this. So we couldn't leave. So we saw what they did. And what they did against the undefeated Wise team was just incredible. And I was scared, very, very scared. We were taking notes when we were watching them. I had my managers film the game. We got back, I stayed up till 3, going over and over watching them play, and they are amazing. And they were amazing again tonight. I was sort of hoping that they couldn't have two games like that. Like, maybe they can just let up just a little after the huge upset. And they surely didn't. And they gave us everything they had. And they, you know, somehow we won. I don't even know how we won. We won in overtime by 3. That's all I know.
You're down 2, 12 seconds left in regulation. Take us through that huddle.
McQuill really wanted the ball. You know, that we knew they were going to press up so the clock would run. So we got it, I believe, to Tyler. He reversed it to LaQuill, and he took it down the court. And is that when we got fouled a couple times?
Yeah.
Everything's like a blur right now.
Now, LaQuill, what do you
call a timeout, inbound ball under your own bucket with 12 seconds left.
Right, and we missed. Now I had to call another one.
No, they kept hitting it out of bounds.
They hit it out of bounds.
Right.
Let's see if you remember, LaQuill.
So, like,
I remember.
What happened
when
on that?
When we started down there, it was 28 seconds left. And I dribbled it up.
Right.
And that's when I passed it to T. Holly, and we called a timeout.
Yeah.
And then we got an inbound, and they hit it out 2 times in a row. And that's when it was 12 seconds.
Take it through. You can kind of get an ice out of your drivers in the bucket.
I couldn't even tell you. I don't even remember.
He just took it.
Something just in me.
Yeah. And it went in.
That was the longest end of fourth quarter in overtime of our lives, I'm sure. It was like, and then did we go up 7 in the overtime? And then they banked the threes. And when were we?
We went up 5.
We went up 5.
Like 3 minutes left in regulation.
Then we think we're good, right? We're good. Right, and then we're pumping up the crowd. And Anthony had a dunk. And, you know, you think you're good. And then bang, bang. And it's just like, we can't shake these guys. Yeah. No matter what.
They just wouldn't let us leave.
Right. They did not want to lose at all.
What's going through your mind when Johnny Banks in that 3?
Oh, I said,
what the heck?
God, what is going on?
I told the ref, I said they could shoot, ref. He was like, that they kind of just walked. Like, you just kept walking. Like, that was
I just
session.
Thought, like, I don't know. Something is going on here.
We all know that things never going to be easy for us for some reason. So it was
always got
easy. It was like, yeah, happening, and we were surprised, exactly. And it was like, oh.
And our horrible free throw.
Question, you shot better from the 4 than the foul line.
Oh,
yeah. And you had to make 4 shots at the end to do that.
Oh, thank the Lord.
Well, when you're sitting there watching it and you're seeing miss after miss, you're like, we're probably going to lose. I mean, when you miss that many free throws in a crucial game, you're scared to death.
Yeah.
Now, when at the end there, he's knocking them down, thank the Lord, you know, we escaped with a win. But, when you miss 10 for 23.
Oh, dang. Geez.
10 for 23. And we
I'm glad we don't have practice anymore.
We really worked on them all week, too, so I promise you we did.
LaQuill, can you talk a little bit about the 4 free throws down the stretch to finally shake those guys, what that feeling was like?
I just cleared my head, didn't think about nothing but a win. Just knocked them down. That's all that was going through my head.
Tyler, that was you with that steal at the end, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, what happened on that? They were trying to...
We were trying to press to make sure they couldn't get the ball down quick and get a shot up. And then Coach B had me and Quill in the back. And they got it to number 2. And then Quill went up, and I saw the guy running behind me. So I knew if that guy was coming down, he was going to pass it. I was either going to fake it and go by me and shoot and probably make it, or I was going to get the steal. And luckily, he threw it, and I was able to slap it out of the air, get the steal, run the timeout, and win the game.
Well, you haven't let go of that trophy since you sat down.
Yeah, my friend, he took it out of his hands when he got it.
What is that? What does that feel like?
Feels great. Last year, we came in here, and we lost. We were young, and we made a vow to come back and win it, and we did it. And I don't think I'm ever going to let this go. I don't know. I can tell y'all.
I told you earlier, I was scared of this team, and I can't believe how good they play. And I mean, Matt Kelly, 22 points, and I'm throwing every guy I can at him to try to slow him down. If you look at that boy, you're like, are you kidding me? I mean, that kid, what year is he?
He's
unbelievable.
He was getting anywhere to.
That was a typical game for him, to be honest with you.
And yeah, and the other thing, like, we go down and watch Wise in the season because we think we might match, like, we knew nothing.
You're not the only one.
We knew nothing. You asked their coach in their press conference, I watched it. He didn't know anything about us, so it was sort of like a cram session. What are we going to do? We're very fortunate.
One more question.
Who wants to?
Who idea was it to play complete tag on
the floor?
It was like
we
a
do that group lot.
Thing. Yeah.
We always do that.
That's just us. Like, we just a bunch of goofballs. That's what we do. That's how we stay energized. That's just us.
Even though you guys are fun, you're fun-loving kids, talk about the maturity that you guys show since that Patterson game, because I was there and I saw some things and I was like, oh no, these guys can do what you just did. Talk about that game and just what you guys have shown since.
That kind of opened our eyes. Like, that made us realize, all right, that made us like really put us in check and made us realize there's a time and a place to do certain things.
We're not untouchable.
Yeah, we thought we were invisible.
I'm so glad Patterson came there.
That was probably one of the best things that could happen to us.
Can't thank them enough for that, because that's why we're here right now. They give us the work ethic again.
I don't want to just add one thing to that. And they came out of their locker room after just winning the state championship and cheered us on when we walked. Yeah, we were going on the court. And that's pretty awesome by that team and Coach Martin.
Much respect.
Well done, boys.
Thanks, everybody.
Want them again, though.